Today I am going to interview you about depression. If you have ever had it and how you handled it. Are you ready?
Yes. Yeah.
Ready. Yes.
Family problems, such as like my parents weren't there, like not there to like encourage me to do stuff, and also like friends and like some drama. That's about it.
There was just stuff going on with my family and stuff.
My parents' divorce. Family problems. It feels like the whole world is against you. It feels like the whole world just collapsed. You feel sad all the time, and you feel like you don't want to do anything, just stay in bed.
It's kind of like a weight that you carry, emotional weight. For me, it kind of changes like your mood. Like you'll be happy a second, and then you'll change. Be like you remember something. That's how it like affects me.
It just feels like you're carrying with it every day. Nobody knows what your struggle is. Like something heavy on your chest. You just get tired of it.
You just not being yourself, you know. You just wake up every morning kind of just hating your life. Just want to find a way out, but just never do. Some people do, though. I want to say, you know, peaking right now, but growing up with depression, you just kind of always have it.
Kind of. I kind of have.
Yeah. I wouldn't beat myself up about it because that was the worst thing I could have possibly did. Because when it feels like I only had myself, I would still like hate my life or hate myself.
I continued going to therapy, and I wouldn't have stopped going. And I forced myself to understand why I'm there and how it's gonna help me.
In some situations, I think I would be more confident in some, because I was kind of like lacking confidence for like some parts, and it kind of like put me down because I didn't get to do some stuff, I guess.
Try to take the right turns, I guess, instead of the wrong ones.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, I have.
Was I good enough?
Like, I don't know. I could like feel sadness from them. I would feel sadness, and they didn't want to talk, or they didn't. You know, they just didn't want to talk. They kind of just, you know, let it happen. In a couple of days, it'll pass by, hopefully. Or they, you know, fake it.
They try to kill themselves.
They got help. They went to counseling.
I don't think at the moment I could have done anything because I was too young. But after I tried anything to help them, I feel like that.
Yeah, I was there for them. If they ever needed to talk about it.
I was there for them. I tried going to therapy with them, to be there with them. I just didn't want them to go through it alone. The way I did.
Other than just talking to them when they wanted.
It can get too personal, to the point where
themselves by rolling the tubes themselves. Or they try hanging themselves, they cut themselves.
A lot, like bad. Because it affects you, like the way you think when you're doing things. And sometimes it's just you wake up in that mood. It's just you have to carry it the whole day and fake things sometimes throughout the day at school.
I think it affects people. Bad, like it'll make them do choices that they normally wouldn't.
In the middle of sometimes when I'm arguing with someone, I feel like I feel like I'm experiencing what my parents went through. Arguing, and I didn't like that.
Yes, I've experienced it back in 8th grade when it first happened.
What caused the depression?
What caused it was when I found out my dad went to prison, and I was very close to him, and what really blew my mind was what he went to prison for.
Can you describe depression in any way?
The only way I can describe depression is I feel lonely, sad, I feel anger. I could also feel like something missing, you know? I could also feel that like I'm not wanted in a way.
Are you still depressed?
There's times where I do get depressed here and there, but I wouldn't say I'm depressed all the time.
If you could go back to when you were depressed, how would you change it?
By just saying it wasn't really worth it, because he wasn't really around, so.
Have you ever encountered someone else with depression?
Yes, I've encountered many people. I have a bunch of friends in my other high school that were always depressed, always cutting. That's pretty much their escape. I had an ex-girlfriend that was very depressed all the time. And the only way that helped her out to release dopamine to get happy and all that was either just me or releasing dopamine from cutting.
What do you think was going through their head?
Why are they here? Why should I be alive if life isn't great? That's pretty much what they told me.
How did they go through it?
Like I said before, they either cut, they dealt with it by not saying I'm not depressed. Either they smoke pot, they did other things, use other synthetics, use medication, which is therapy. They just went through life with it. Either way, you know, they're like, okay, I'm depressed. I'm gonna just deal with it. That's pretty much it.
Did you try to help them in any way?
Yeah, I helped a bunch. Of course, I wasn't a doctor, you know. I was like, you know, dude, here, smoke a joint because it smells like a pothead. But then, some of them helped, not all. I told them, have you gone to your doctor about it? Have you actually, like, what are you actually going through, you know? And either way, I've always been there for them. I've talked to them throughout the day. I'm like, hey, man, how you feeling? You know, if you're doing great, that's awesome. Just keep it up, you know? Always give them a heads up, like, you know, you have a reason why you're here, you know? Depression is just a feeling that you're getting right now. Later on, you'll be better. You know, try to give them as much positivity as possible.
How bad do you think depression affects somebody?
How much I've seen it, how much I dealt with it. Like I say, it's really hard. You know, it's something that can really impact you for a long time, actually. I've seen someone actually been in depression for more than 8 years, I would say. You know, he's my best friend. He's gone through a lot through his life. You know, and right now he's still making it. He's making his life a lot better. He's, you know, choosing the right path. He's just going through it. So I would say it's difficult to get away from depression. It's really hard.
Have you ever encountered someone with depression?
Yes, a lot.
And what did you do to help?
You know, for people that have depression, a lot of times it helps for them to talk, to be able to know that they're not alone, that there's somebody there that, you know, understands or that listens, that can talk them through certain things. Because a lot of times people that have depression feel isolated. They feel like it's just them in the world, that nobody understands, that they don't have anybody that they can talk to about whatever they're feeling or not feeling. Because a lot of times people that are depressed, they completely shut down. They don't know how to handle the emotions. And so sometimes they block out all emotions and they are completely numb. So a lot of times for me, just talking to somebody to let them know that they're not alone, it helps them to, you know, just discuss whatever that they're trying to not think about. And sometimes that helps just to, as a release, just to get it out.
How different do you think depression affects guys versus girls?
The one thing about depression is it affects everybody differently. Whether you're male, female, it doesn't matter. Everybody's chemistry is different. Everybody's mind works differently. Nobody is the same. So I can't really say how different it would be, male versus female, because everybody's their own individual. Everybody's different. I think there's a stigma for males when it comes to depression and when it comes to counseling, therapy, any kind of mental health. They feel like, you know, they have to be a strong male, you know, and that tears are bad, emotions are bad. So I think for a lot of guys, they're a little put off by that because they feel like they should be able to handle it themselves. You know, girls, a lot of times they're a little more open with their emotions. But depression affects everybody differently. You know, you can't really pinpoint one symptom over another for male versus female.
What do you think is the best approach to somebody who's depressed?
You know, that really depends. Because some people are severely depressed. I mean, where they are just can't get out of the bed in the morning. They don't care about their own well-being. They're, you know, taking a shower is a struggle. You know, and other people, they just are kind of in a funk, you know, they just feel sad. They can't pinpoint what really is the matter. You know, there's just varying degrees of it. I think it really just depends on what's going on for a person. A lot of people, you know, go through grief and that causes depression. Some people, it's a chemical imbalance that it's out of their control. It's something that they're not even aware of that's going on. And the situation just kind of snowballs, it escalates over time. So I think it just depends on the person and what they're going through. The one thing I will say is, for anybody who ever feels like it's out of their control, that they don't know what to do, they feel helpless, hopeless, you know, they really do need to get help for it, because depression's a hard one, and you can't do it on your own. A lot of people need to go see somebody, a doctor, that can diagnose them with it, because a lot of people do need to take medications. They need to take some antidepressants to help with the chemical imbalance, to help them be able to start thinking clearly so that they can start making better decisions to help themselves get better. And for some people, they just need to talk to somebody. Because, you know, it may not be a chemical imbalance, and maybe, like I said, they're going through some grief, or they've had, you know, some trauma in their life, some abuse, or whatever it may be. And some people can get past it just by, you know, talking it out, going through some therapy, seeing, you know, a mental health practitioner, and other people really do need some medications, because sometimes depression is a side effect of maybe something else that's more prevalent. There could be a medical illness that's going on that is, you know, triggering the depression. So if somebody ever feels like, you know, they're not quite sure what's going on, it's always best to go get checked just to make sure. Because sometimes depression can lead to, you know, some pretty serious issues, you know, suicidal ideation, just, you know, not taking care of themselves, hurting other people. So it's always best just to figure it out and get help. You know, you can talk yourself out of it, but for a lot of people, it's really powerful, and it takes over.
Alright, so today we're here to talk about depression, and if you have ever met somebody who's had it, so, yeah. Have you ever encountered somebody with depression?
Yes,
I have that question.
What did you do to help them?
Well, depression is a mental health condition that affects many people, many of us. Probably every one of us go through depression at some point of our life. It's just a bit of the degree of the problem. I have worked with people who had depression that is able to be managed with therapy, but then there are some others that require a combination of therapy and medication.
Do you know how they got through it?
Well, like I told you, depression is a condition that is, you know, the chemicals on your brain are not level or not working properly. So sometimes by following a therapy, working through it, talking about it, recognizing the problem, and having a plan about what to do when the person starts feeling depressed, that will help. But sometimes medication is necessary, because even with the plan, even with the therapy, the person is still feeling depressed. So sometimes medication will help to level those chemicals in the brain, and little by little that person starts feeling better, feeling more energy with starting their normal life.
How bad do you think depression affects somebody?
It can be very dangerous. It can be, if somebody suffers depression and it's not treated, it can become chronic, and then it can be a life-threatening.
What do you think is the most effective thing to do with somebody that is that has depression?
Well, first of all, it's important to recognize when somebody is going through depression. Because, you know, we have the idea that somebody that is depressed is somebody that is crying every day, or and it's not. You know, sometimes people with depression will show that depression by being really angry and become aggressive. And that's part of the depression, especially That's the difference between males and females. Females, we are allowed to cry, and we cry a lot, and so we know we are able to show our depression. Males, many times, because there's that stigma that males don't cry, they show their depression by being angry, by being oppressive. So the best way is to identify when somebody is going through depression, and then, once we recognize that we have a problem, what are we going to do with that? Because just knowing that we have a problem is not enough. We recognize that we have something going on, but it's different, and then ask for help and follow through with it. Because one of the mistakes we made is sometimes when people it's recommended to take medication, if they don't like the feeling of by taking the medication, they just stop the medication, and that doesn't help. It's better to follow the medical recommendations and find out the right treatment for that person.
Have you ever experienced depression?
Yes, I have.
What caused the depression?
Oh, that's a good question. I would say that the actual moment of when I started feeling depressed was in seventh grade, and back when I was in school, our school system was grade 7 through 9 and 10 through 12. And I was 13, and as adolescents do, things change, friends come and go, and friends that I had initially in school were suddenly not friends anymore, and never understood the reasons why behind that. But primarily I think that what was at the root of the depression was ever since I was little, I always grew up with the feeling of, that I didn't belong, that I somehow didn't fit in, that there was something wrong with me, which stemmed from in part, an encounter with a neighbor boy that happens to many little girls and little boys, being taken advantage of at the age of 4, but not recognizing that that was at the time, or at least in part of it. It was also the fact that I was raised in a town that was primarily white, primarily straight. There wasn't a lot of diversity, and growing up I didn't know that I was gay. And in my hometown that was hugely frowned upon, and so being young and not recognizing that that was an actual orientation, I felt a feeling of alienation. And while it sounds funny, when I was little, I used to think that I would, in order to be happy, I should be a man. So I planned on early age that when I grew up, I was going to have a sex change and become a man. And then come eighth grade, the kids, my peers, were starting to harass me and, call me gay, and, oh, she's a lesbian, and, they said mean things and constantly harassed me, although I hadn't pleased to know, even though they threatened to beat me up on a daily basis, they never did. And I had the realization in eighth grade that, oh, that's what, I am gay. And so that was really eye-opening. However, the depression continued because my grades struggled, and my brothers were always did well in school and praised more highly by my parents, and so I felt less than, and I felt that I wasn't very smart. And so the depression was just compounded by external forces like that. And while I tried very hard to do well in school, for some reason it never worked out well. So it just continued to go downhill, and my parents put me in therapy, and I tried various medications, but nothing worked. And then by the time I graduated from high school, those things that, friends and such, they were there, and that was life. And then, long story short,
I started to drink as a way to cope with depression. And then at the age of 21, I had a life-threatening accident, a very serious one, which I would be happy to tell you at a later time. And as a result of that accident, I had, as some call, an epiphany, which literally means an appearance of a deity, but is really used as an aha moment, that I wanted to be happy and I wanted to live my life that where I was productive and have a happy, productive life. So I joined an organization that helped me do that, and I worked exceptionally hard to become self-aware, to know the roots of my depression, of my anxieties and what have you. So since the age of 22, I have constantly striven to work through any negative emotions and have learned a great deal about being self-aware and changing things from negative to positive. So I can now say in all honesty that, and I've, you know, as most of us, as many of us have been through an awful lot of horrible things, I know how to cope, and I know how to, and I handle things with emotional maturity and look at things versus feeling sorry for myself or looking at things as a problem. I now look at things as a chance to find a solution to my problems and, you know, read and learn a lot in order to cope with life's struggles and life's joys. And in part, the depression actually is why I became a teacher, because when I was 14, 15, I remember thinking to myself I wanted to be the kind of teacher that, you know, would always remember what it was like to be a kid and, you know, not to be discounted as, oh, you're just a teenager going through emotions, because oftentimes it's actually, it's not just adolescence and the changing of hormones, but it can be a whole heck of a lot more.
If you can describe how depression feels in any way.
It's incredibly heavy. And to provide a picture, if I can, I remember at the age of 14 looking out at my parents' back door in a, you know, beautiful backyard, beautiful house, and just, it felt as though I was looking into, it's just like looking into a tunnel. And it's not only is it a visual, but it's like a feeling. It's like, it feels like you're compressed and the only thing you can see is just like what's in front of you. It creates the inability to think outside of, well, I can only speak for me, to speak outside, to see outside of myself. And it feels like something that doesn't go away, won't go away, and feels like it's something that's going to go on forever. And again, that was another big component of learning how to deal with it, is recognizing that feelings are ephemeral. I think I taught you guys that word, which are fleeting and things change. And that if, as long as I'm active in changing them, an active participant, then they do change. And then they change for the better, and therefore making you a far more strong person and actually that much more interesting. I think that it depends on the person. I would say that for some people it makes living other parts of their lives incredibly difficult, like not being able to focus on other tasks at hand. I think some people are able to, you know, pretend through the depression, but then have it as a constant reminder in the back of their mind. I would think that for me, and I can only speak from experience, is that having that depression, it was just, it was very limiting, and it was, what's the word I'm looking for? It made me, like, unable to, one, you know, enjoy life, but two, like, think about, you know, the future.
Depression's tough. I've seen a lot kids go through it. I've got family members that go through it. I think the best thing is just, the hardest thing is to recognize you are depressed. I think it's hard to get out of your skin long enough to see that. But just try to get some help. I mean, there's people you can call. There's lines or, you know, suicide hotlines. There's several things that you can do. Just try to get help, because it's a devastating disease. And if you do wind up committing suicide, it doesn't fix the problem. It just kind of expands it. And that it makes it even all that more devastating. You can get through it. I've seen people have amazing lives, especially once they get through it, get some help, figure out, you know, maybe they need medication, whatever, but just try to reach out at least that little bit and get some help, because it's definitely